In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the new Adobe Creative Profiles in both Lightroom and Photoshop, and I'm also going to give you completely free a sample pack of 5 profiles along with raw files to practice. I'm Tim from timsphotos.com. I'm a landscape photographer and I'm here to help you take your photography from good to great. So let's just talk about these new Adobe profiles for a second. This, in my view, is the best thing that Adobe has done in the past decade for Lightroom and Photoshop. And it's completely changed the way that I process my images. It has been a huge time saver for me. And it helps me create more wow type of image in half the time. So just a quick word about presets versus profiles. Now, presets have been in existence for years and years and years. Presets are the old ones. I'm not a huge fan of presets, but profiles were only introduced to Lightroom and Photoshop in April 2018. So they're brand new and they are designed to help you create more beautiful photos in much less time so that you have more time to be out shooting your landscapes and less time in front of the computer editing. So I'm going to share my screen and show you how to use these profiles.
First, I'll just show you where you can get your free sample pack of profiles. If you go to timsphotos.com/profiles and click on the blue button here, and this way you can download a free sample pack of the new Adobe profiles, as well as 5 raw photos that I'm going to show you in this quick tutorial. So this is a raw photo of Moraine Lake, and the starting point is to go into the develop module in Lightroom and make sure that you can see these 4 squares here and the word profile. If you cannot see them in your copy of Lightroom, then you need to update Lightroom. So I've got the timsphotos.com profile sample set installed here. So I click on the 4 little squares, and this is the untouched raw. And what I love about profiles, I mean, it's just such a night and day difference between profiles, which are new, and the old presets. Let's look at the old presets. The old presets, you have to one by one go through until you see something that you like. And it's very difficult because you can't see them all at the same time. And it's difficult for your eye to recognize which image you like the best when maybe a good one was 7 images ago. Whereas with profiles, you can see them all at the same time. And I just, from looking at this, I can see that I like this one over here better. I like this one the best. So I can also mouse over the other ones and I see, wow, that's a really cold edit. And this one here, well, the sky is really washed out. This one, not bad actually. And this one here, not loving it, but this one I love because it has the warmth in the sky. I see the warmth of the sun. It's brightened up the foreground. So I just click it to select, then come to the top. And this is the best thing about profiles right here. I love this option, is that it's already set at 100%. But if I found that it was too much, I can back it off down to whatever I want to. Or if I want more of the effect, I can go above 100%. So I'm just going to leave it at 100% here. And then click close. And this is now my starting point for my editing. All of my sliders are at the 0 point, and I can start some fresh editing from this point. So it's a fantastic starting point. Let's take a look at a second image. This one here is called Spirit Island. We're looking at the raw. We're looking at this nasty dust spot in the cloud, which is what happens when you go traveling. But I click into the profiles and I'm looking at the sample set again. And this is the one that I love. Now, obviously, this is the profile that was created for this photo specifically. But once again, I can select on it. I can choose 100% more or less, then click close, and then start my editing on it. Let's look at one more example. Here's a shot of Paris. from the tallest building in Paris during an awesome sunset. This was the day before Bastille Day, which is the French national holiday on July 14th, when all the fireworks happen on the Eiffel Tower. It was just such a magical time to be there. So let's take a look at which profile is going to light this thing up and make it completely come to life. And without even without clicking on anything, I can see that I like the top two the best. This one here has too much of a tint to it. It just doesn't look natural enough. But this one here has that natural look. So I select it. I decide if I want 100% or not, and I click close. And there again is the starting point of my edit. So let's take a look at another one from France, Mont Saint-Michel. Get into the profiles by clicking on the four squares and take a look at the ones that I've got done. This one, I'm not loving the sky. This one, way too orange. This one here, not bad, but the foreground is too dark. This one, I'm liking it. Maybe the foreground's maybe a little bit too light, but this one here, it's just right. So click on it and select close. And now I can start additional editing. One more, and then I'm going to show you the Photoshop experience. So this one here is the Palouse region of Washington State. An absolutely gorgeous farming community with rolling hills. And let's click into our profiles. I'm just looking at the broad view. I think this one here is a great start. This one here, I'm just going to go between the two. This one versus this one. I'm liking this one. I click on it. I click close. And now I can do any other additional edits to it if I really need to. Now let's jump over to Photoshop. I'm in the raw editor, so the Adobe Creative Profiles only work when you're in the raw editor. You want to make sure you're on the basic tab right here, and then you want to make sure you can see the word profile. Make sure you see the four squares. If you don't see them, then you need to upgrade your version of Photoshop. So I'm going to click on the four squares, and here are the seven profiles that come with Photoshop. And none of them do it for me. None of them are opening up the shadows enough. None of them are creating the colors that I want. So I'm going to close the Adobe Raw, the one that comes with it. And I'm going to go down to the Tim's Photos sample pack. And you'll notice all these other different packs. This is if you purchase the full collection for $27. But if you've just opted to get the free sample pack, it's going to be the Tim's Photos sample pack. And I'm liking this one. That is a nice edit. That is a really nice edit, actually. I like that a lot. And since I know that this is an HDR photo, I want to go into the HDRs and just take a look at what I have here. Looking down, not loving it. But boy, I sure like that one that this one here is too yellow in the sky. But going back to the sample pack, this one, Moraine Lake, I love it. I think this is a fantastic starting point. Do I need a little less of the edit? Maybe. Maybe I'm going to go just 95% on it. I could go up higher even if I wanted to, but no, 95% on that one. And then I'm going to close it. And then I'm back to my raw editor and I can make adjustments from there. And this is looking like the start of just an absolutely gorgeous photo.
I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you found value in it, then I would ask that you please consider liking this video, as well maybe leaving a comment, but maybe most importantly, subscribing to my YouTube channel, which is very similar to following somebody on Instagram. It's free to do so, and it just shows your support for the work that I'm creating. It would mean a lot to me. And if you haven't already received your free sample set of Adobe Creative Profiles, then please visit timsphotos.com/profiles and you can download a sample set there. And included with that sample set is the 5 raw files that I used in this tutorial. I hope you enjoy. Thanks so much.